My name is Ross Lovegrove. I'm a designer, more of an industrial designer, and we're here in Clerkenwell at the Moroso showroom for the launch of my Diatom chair and some other lovely British products. What I like about Patrizia in her art direction is that she's always seen something very special here, in certainly in London, and she supported a lot of up-and-coming people. If you look at the designers that have been identified by Moroso, there's a really good balance, and there's a lot of spontaneity in British design. It's pretty fearless, I think. When I first started on my own, that was in 1990, Patrizia gave me a chance, and I did this sofa system called M, which was related to Moroso, and the shape of the arm is an M, and I looked at elegant seating. I just wanted to design something which, if you were meeting your bank manager, you wouldn't have to sort of flop your way out of. And actually at home, it's still the sofa I sit on after best part of 24 years, I think. The supernatural chair was a bit of a breakthrough. Polymers have really advanced in the last decade. It's incredible. And so it's a great opportunity to do a sort of lightweight, very universal language stacking chair, and my ambition was to do the lightest that I could. And the holes that are in it are not there for decoration, they are actually there to liberate the material. So I'm not interested in decoration particularly as a superficial thing. I'm interested to produce something which is at the time state of the art, but which could even improve over time. So as a polymer chair, means a lot to me because I can liquefy form, which I can't really do very easily with other materials. Well, the new opportunity has been this Diatom chair, and I confess that for many years I wanted to work on an aluminium chair. If you notice in my oeuvre, I try to identify a material or a technology, then I design. And it's informed by nature, it's not inspired by nature, it's informed by nature because it's absolute minimum material, maximum object, and I just love the idea of a vertical stack through itself, and for me that's kind of very normal. And then we 3D printed these models in the studio and it just worked beautifully. The name Diatom comes from its silica based oceanic creature, and it's something that is part of the lineage of my philosophy, which is to, in a biomimical sense, draw some references and some inspiration from things which have had a long time to evolve, become very succinct in their material use, lightweight, dematerialized. So that's where that comes from.